Hi everybody! In this video, we will focus on a fascinating topic, the step-by-step process IBM's data science team applies when working on a consulting project. We believe this overview can be highly beneficial for both experienced professionals and data science beginners. We'll explore a best practice framework applied by one of the pioneer and leading companies in the field. This way, you'll get an insider's look at how a consulting project that involves data analysis and data science unfolds. In addition, we'll examine the results achieved in IBM's data science consulting projects with major clients from different industries. Why is that important? Well, each of these initiatives serves as an invaluable lesson to the rest of the companies in the respective industry. If, for example, Carrefour managed to leverage AI to improve its supply chain processes, the rest of the global hypermarket chains would basically be obliged to follow if they want to keep up. All right, let's get right in and outline the five stages of a data science consulting project. Stage 1. Engage the firm's CTO. Stage 2. Meet with the company's SMEs and brainstorm. 3. Data collection and modeling through coding sprints. 4. Visualization and communication of findings. And finally, follow-up projects. Each of these steps of the process is vital, so let me elaborate a bit further by describing them one by one in more detail. Things start with a conversation with the firm's chief technology officer. He needs to be sold on the project. Hopefully, this would result in him championing and endorsing the initiative across the organization. Such buy-in enables cooperation and improves the project's chances of success. At this stage, the consulting team and the CTO will define the scope of work and the lowest hanging fruits, which will give an immediate boost in terms of bottom line results. What we mean by lowest hanging fruit is an opportunity that the data science team knows is available for most companies in an industry and is easiest to implement. For example, they have seen on a few occasions that supermarket chains can greatly reduce food waste if they implement a predictive AI model, able to adjust the timing of deliveries. So, an absolute best practice when working on consulting projects is to address such opportunities first, because this gives instant credibility to the project team and wins support across the organization. Once the project scope has been identified with a firm's CTO, the data science consulting team will proceed to brainstorm on how AI can be applied in the particular use cases that have been pre-selected. To envision this a bit better, the team needs to conduct a series of interviews and meetings with subject matter experts, the people who work in the business day in and day out, and who are able to contribute greatly in terms of identifying actionable and meaningful solutions. Also, in most cases, SMEs are the ones who have a good idea of what data is available and can be used for the purposes of the project at hand. The next stage consists of coding sprints. This is the main chunk of the work, so IBM's team organizes it in three parts. One for collecting data and feature modeling. Data collection sounds like getting the data from all places, but it may be much trickier. Depending on the scope of the project, the consulting company may need to first consolidate all data in one place, called a data warehouse. In some cases, not enough data is being collected, and new data sources must be set up. Feature modeling is inside this step, as features may be chosen from the available data. Sometimes, however, very important metrics are not being measured. The consulting firm can then suggest starting to collect data on that, thus changing the data collection structure of the client. Another sprint for feature selection and running the model for the first time. Once data has been collected and features have been modeled, it is time for some data science. While features were modeled and kind of selected during the first sprint, they were never tested in a model. So, in the second coding sprint, features are evaluated, transformed, or new features are engineered, this time for predictive modeling purposes. Once this is done, the first models come to life, showing the potential to the stakeholders in the client company. And a third sprint to fine-tune the model and adjust it as per client requirements. The moment a solid model has been thought through and executed, the fine-tuning begins. There are many ways in which a model can be improved. A 1% increase in accuracy could imply millions of dollars in savings for the client company. Therefore, this step should not be overlooked, even if it sounds like the least exciting one. Okay, moving on to the fourth stage, data visualization. Data visualization plays a critical role in most data science projects. However, please bear in mind that the specialists who build a model are not always the ones best equipped to work on the visualization of its findings. When presenting in front of a non-technical business team, it is much better to show Tableau or Power BI graphs rather than a Jupyter notebook. And hence, the data science consulting team needs skills related to chart and dashboard creation, as well as the ability to communicate in an effective way. It is not uncommon to have a person whose job is to solely style such findings, giving the final touch to the presentation. And this is how we reach the fifth stage, namely, follow-up projects. As with any other type of consulting, the secret sauce of being a successful consultant is to be able to sell the next project, and then to sell the next one after that, and so on. The premise is that if the consulted company sees a measurable bottom line improvement, they will certainly want to retain the consulting team, and will be willing to purchase additional services, from IBM in our example. This is also why consulting firms prefer to start with low-hanging fruits. This allows them to show they can create value very fast, and hence they improve their chances of being hired again. Alright, now that we've figured out the typical cycle of a data science consulting project, let's take a look at some of the successful use cases IBM's elite data science consulting team helped with. Starting with Nedbank. In the case of Nedbank, a South African bank, a model predicting ATM's need for repair was implemented, and this led to important efficiencies in terms of ATM reliability and maintenance timeliness. In another project, IBM's data science team helped JP Morgan implement a model, which prevented the bank's traders from engaging with trades that are not recommended by JP Morgan's powerful predictive models. Experian is one of the leading companies in the information business industry. They analyze credit payments on a global scale for a number of institutions. In this case, IBM's team helped Experian leverage unstructured data and combine it with structured data that was traditionally used in Experian's models to build a more comprehensive view of the businesses Experian is hired to analyze. One can argue that data science and AI consulting is a business in its infancy, and it appears that the most important ingredient IBM's team has mastered is the combination of technical know-how in terms of data science modeling and business understanding. Truth is, a successful data science project needs both. This is precisely why we try to teach you how data science can be applied in a business context in every course of the 365 Data Science program. So, if you'd like to explore this further or enroll using a 20% discount, there's a link in the description you can check out. We hope you found this video helpful. If you enjoyed the topic, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to our channel here on YouTube. In the upcoming months, we will prepare tons of other useful career-oriented data science videos you don't want to miss on. Thanks for watching!